you gotta teach kids how to deal with bullying, because it's gonna happen, whether it's physical, mental, you know what I mean? You just gotta learn how. My parents was good at that. My parents was pretty good. My mother and father still together. They were great parents. I was talking to my father today. I know you don't believe me because I'm black, but I know who he is. My father was there. He was a good dad, too. He took me fishing, played catch with me, didn't touch me at night. You can't ask for better parents. That's how you ask from your parents, right? Take me fishing every once in a while. I don't play up my balls when I go to sleep. We have a great relationship. It was very supportive when I decided to move to New York to do comedy, because I moved here from a fucking small town. I moved here with this naive innocence. My father was supportive. My mother was like, she's very, you know, conservative and religious. She's like, you're gonna get stabbed and raped and robbed. I'm like, what? I'm going to New York, not prison. I might get robbed, I might even get stabbed, but I seriously doubt somebody's gonna fuck me up my ass against my will. That shit don't happen in the streets. You ever been fucked up your ass against your will, sir? Absolutely not. That only happens in prison when you drop the soap. Every time I drop the soap in the shower, I think of ass fucking in prison. I don't know why. I drop the soap, I go, oh God, if I was in prison, somebody would fucking take advantage of my asshole. Every single time I drop the soap, I say, oh shit. I'm glad I'm in Brooklyn. My mother's really religious, man. Annoyingly religious. Almost to the point, like, she's like a fanatic. Like, you can't have a normal conversation with my mother without her bringing Jesus into it. Like, you'd be talking about chocolate chip cookies, and she'll find a way to try to correlate Jesus. You're like, Chips Ahoy is actually the Hebrew word for the, like, stop making shit up, man. Jesus ain't got nothing to do with Chips Ahoy. I was home visiting recently, and my friends kept coming over to see me because they hadn't seen me in a while, and she started quoting the Bible. You know it's saying in the Bible that if you go visit your neighbor's house too much, they'll get tired of you and grow to hate you? I go, it doesn't say that. And she goes, yes, it does. She whipped the Bible out. She keep hers in a holster. She pulled it out. She turned right to the page. It was in there. It was in Proverbs. It says, do not go over your neighbor's house a lot, otherwise they'll get tired of you. I was like, wow, the Bible is everything. You can live your life by the Bible. Then I was curious. I go, who wrote that book? She goes, King Solomon wrote that book. And a light bulb went off immediately. If anybody know who King Solomon was, he had gold and bitches. He lived in a castle. Of course he had unwanted guests. How convenient that he wrote that part. That's not funny. God inspired him to write every word. Not that part. He probably was writing something God told him to write to those pervert and freeloading neighbors knocking on the door. Now, should not, never, yes, Lord, this is good stuff. Hey, yo, Solomon, what's up, man? It's Chris. That's, I don't know his real biblical name, but his name is Chris for the story. And Chris is like, yo, it's Tuesday, we going out? And Solomon got upset, like, look, Chris, every time you come over here, every Tuesday, you constantly disrespect what I do. You have no respect that I write the Bible. And you know what? Never mind. Excuse me, Lord. Do not visit your neighbor's house. Otherwise, they will hate your guts. I got to put this in here. They come over here every Tuesday. You see them. Now, no one of them is trying to fuck one of my wives. It's the 209th one that's been distant. Solomon had a lot of wives. He might as well give his friend one, right? Ain't no fun if my homies can't have none. That's what Snoop Dogg said.